Hi, my name is Jason K. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. Today in this video, we're going to talk about a CSS property called display. Before we start writing some codes, I want to show you some common CSS properties that you have to know. There are a lot of styles that you can apply to your HTML elements, but some are used more than others. So today I'm going to show you some of these properties that are more frequently used to help you write your code better. The first one that I want to talk about is display. In programming, the word display means to show on a screen. So this display property determines how your HTML elements are shown or displayed on your web page. There are four display properties I want to talk about today. Block, inline, inline block, and none. The first one is block. The block property takes up the entire width no matter short how your content is. Let's get some examples. If you look at these div elements, they are by default block elements, and they take up the entire width even if the sentence is shorter than the other one. The next one is inline. The span elements by default are inline elements. They take up the minimum width possible. So even if you set properties like width and height, it's not going to be applied. Let's take a look. You see nothing changes. But like I said, this one is default property, so you can set your span to be explicitly block and add the width and height values that you want. Like this. The third one is inline block. Inline blocks are basically inline, so it takes up the minimum width, but you can apply the width and height values that you want. Like that. The last one is none. Just like the name says, it's like your HTML element never existed. Disappears. These are the four display properties that are commonly used. There are also properties called flex and grid. These two are very important, but also very complicated. You gotta add some extra properties along with them to use them properly, so I'll talk about them in separate sessions. In the next video, I'm gonna talk about a CSS property called position. This property allows you to position or locate your HTML elements. And just as always, if you wanna learn something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you, and stay tuned.